Tonight's Tempo in Depth explores air travel and the impact it has on our economy. When was the last time you flew somewhere? Did you fly out of the Lehigh Valley International Airport? Or did you head to the bigger cities nearby, possibly to save some cash? I'll sit down and talk travel with the executive director of the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority. Plus, we'll take a look at the impact our airport has on our businesses and our economy. Stick around as we learn more about air travel and its impact on tonight's Tempo in Depth.
Support for Tempo in Depth is provided by the members of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. The skies might be as friendly as ever, but they don't have as many people flying through them. So far this year, all major airlines have reported having fewer passengers. Yet, over 28,000 commercial flights take off every day in this country. Research shows the travel industry as a whole is down 11% because of the recession. And while airlines have used 5% less gas, their fuel costs have increased by $16 billion. In our own region, the Lehigh Valley International Airport, by December, expects to offer at least 27 daily flights to 12 destinations on 8 and could be 9 airlines soon. And yes, LVIA faces the same obstacles as other airports, fluctuating fuel prices and a recession. Yet LVIA continues to cruise along and plays a major part in the local economy. Tempo in Depth's Grover Silcox tells us more.
Come on, fly with me. We'll fly away. Come fly with me. We'll float down to Peru.
Air travel today may seem a lot less inviting than these lyrics imply.
I normally tell my clients to get to the airport 2.5-3 hours early if it's an international airport.
Sometimes a relaxing vacation ends at the airport before a traveler ever takes off.
Clients who are a little bit nervous about traveling, Lehigh Valley International Airport is wonderful. You're not going to get lost, and you know the area, so it's easy to get to, and it's you feel safe going there.
When Jennifer Donchez's travel clients express an aversion to flying out of Philly or Newark, she suggests Lehigh Valley International. LVIA offers fewer flights, but also fewer hassles than the big airports.
You're not going to take a lot of time to get through security, and it's very comfortable. It's not overwhelming. It's a comfortable airport, very easy to maneuver around.
Glenn Walbert, chairman of the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority, sees other benefits as well.
We have a pretty good cross-section of destinations. We have several non-stops going to Florida. We have a non-stop to Atlanta, Chicago, Washington, D.C., and from those locations, you could get flights to virtually anywhere in the United States.
Sally McCorson of AAA applauds LVIA as the big little airport with major airlines offering competitive fares and minimal stress.
I did some fare searches yesterday on 3 destinations, and in every instance, LVIA was less expensive or competitive.
A quick internet check showed one such comparison on a flight to Orlando.
Currently to LVIA yesterday, we came up with $124.84 round trip to Orlando. Philadelphia on Southwest was $182.80 and Newark was $239.20.
Those who book better fares out of Philly or Newark fail to ask themselves certain questions, such as,
what am I going to spend in gas to get there? And what am I going to spend for parking?
Sally claims they can save on both at LVIA. Certainly, there are far more flights out of Newark and Philly, but there are far more people to contend with as well. Last year, Newark served over 35 million passengers and Philly over 33 million. LVIA served over 779,000. It hopes to attract more travelers with major renovations now in the works, but essentially it promises to remain far less congested than the mega airports.
Certainly we're between two huge airports, but the reality is both those airports are at near capacity, and they certainly got a reprieve because of the recession. But when things pick up again, those airports can't really add a lot of new service. And Lehigh Valley is a logical place for additional service to be offered.
LVIA has already improved service with the addition of low-fare carriers, AirTran and Allegiant, two airlines doing well in a declining industry, according to airport expert Brad DeFiore.
Now what you're seeing is even the low-fare carriers starting to slow down their growth. In fact, all of them are shrinking this year for the first time in history. except for Allegiant Air.
Important for its nonstops to Florida.
And it's a straight flight, and it's cheap through Allegiant Air. So we leave right out of Orlando, Sanford, come right up here, and we've been flying this actual airline for 5 years now.
That's convenient for folks going to St. Petersburg or who don't mind driving to Disney. Those who prefer going directly to Disney can take AirTrans nonstop right to Orlando.
AirTran now has announced they're now also going to be adding Saturdays to Orlando. So they have, I believe, 5 days a week now.
In addition to leisure passengers, LVI serves lots of business travelers.
Certainly you could go to Philly to catch a flight, but it's not as convenient as being here at Lehigh Valley, and all the other services we provide are invaluable, particularly for new businesses that are considering coming into the Lehigh Valley.
LVIA provides people a convenient way to fly, but what does it do for the regional economy?
There were some economic studies done in the past and came up with numbers like $338 million in economic impact to the Lehigh Valley.
But what about the future of LVIA?
It has to serve its community and serve its airlines in a cost-effective fashion. And that's one of the big advantages that we've seen, is that we can do that.
But LVIA must attract more people from within a 40-mile radius to reach peak performance.
We have to support the airport. They can do everything to bring in these carriers, but if there aren't people on the planes, you know, an airline can't afford to lose business, so we have to support the airport. If people keep going to Philly or Newark or Kennedy, that's not going to help the community, the local businesses, the airport, or any of us in the Lehigh Valley.
Whether navigating through economic turbulence or sailing on rising economic tailwinds, the Lehigh Valley International Airport promises to stay on course, inviting travelers to come fly from the airport that served them and the region since 1935. For Tempo in Depth, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Thanks so much, Grover. We're going to continue our conversation about air travel out of the Lehigh Valley International Airport with a special guest joining me in the studio. We've got George Dowdy. He's the executive director of the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority. George, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you.
You know, when we were chatting, it's interesting how things have changed. Air travel out of LVIA before 9/11 was predominantly business travel. You told me about 55% business travel, 45% leisure travel. Since 9/11, we're looking at 60% leisure travel out of there and 40% business travel. What do you think has made things change so much?
Well, I think most of that change occurred in the last year or two as a result of the high fuel prices, the reduction in flying by the airlines, and then the recession that really began to affect business travel across the country dramatically. And so we've seen business travel drop off. With the lower fuel prices, leisure seats became available at a reasonable price, and we've gotten service from new leisure carriers, Allegiant, Direct Air, AirTran now going to directly to Florida. So that has given us additional available seats, and more people have chosen to fly for leisure purposes. We assume, we can't count that for sure. And at the same time, business travel has been reduced. We think that will come back in the next few years a little bit, maybe back toward the 50-50 mark that it was before.
Now, we saw in Grover's story that the folks from AAA did a comparison and actually found a lower rate to head to Orlando out of Lehigh Valley International Airport as opposed to Philadelphia or Newark. Now, I got to give you my personal take on this, which Orlando's my favorite place to go on vacation with my family, and I'm never that lucky. I always find cheaper flights out of the larger carriers in the bigger cities.
You're the exception, if you check every time. If you check every time, there are going to be times when Philadelphia or Newark, and maybe even the majority of times, will have a lower fare. But in many of those cases, if you consider the cost of parking and the cost of driving and your time, flying from Lehigh Valley can be less expensive. Now, if you're dealing with a family of four, obviously the difference is more significant. On a single person going on a trip, it's not quite as much. But it's all about competition. And with less competition from certain airlines at Lehigh Valley to certain markets, the fares are going to be higher because the airlines simply can get that. And they'll be happy to take your $600 to go to Atlanta from Lehigh Valley, and if you don't like that, they'll take your $300 down at Philadelphia.
So they're going to get it either way.
Yeah, they're going to get something anyway. So it's a matter of being careful and checking each time you fly as to what the fares are, and getting being a little bit sophisticated and a little bit knowledgeable about how the fares work and advance purchase. And obviously, the earlier you can book, the better deal you get usually. And so. We just say that the best way to use Lehigh Valley is to make sure you check all the fares each time you fly. Don't just assume that flights from Lehigh Valley are always going to be higher.
And there is another concern sometimes because there are limited flights, smaller airport, smaller number of planes leaving versus some of the larger airports, and you often can't get the times that you're looking to go. And that's a challenge, I think, for some families out there. As you head off to vacation, you don't want a later in the afternoon flight. You miss your whole first day of vacation trying to get down there. But do you think that's supply and demand? As all those flights fill up, do you see even the newer low-cost AirTran and Allegiant offering more flights?
Well, in the Orlando market, for example, during the peak season of the winter and the summer peak, because there's a summer peak for Orlando, we begin to get multiple flights per day to Orlando. And when that happens, then yeah, you'll get a morning option and an evening option. In the shoulder periods that we are in now, like September and October, the carriers are offering less than daily service, so it's whatever they want to provide that particular day and what schedule works for them operationally, so that you'll have less choice. And as the market grows, and I think both AirTran and Allegiant, who serve the two airports in Orlando, are beginning to realize that there's almost no end to our Orlando market. They keep adding seats, and people will just sort of come out of the woodwork to get on them. Orlando is just such a popular destination, and it's
your number one.
It's our number
destination,
one, right? And it's a destination in itself, and it also you can go from there to other points in Florida, and in some cases, for example, Allegiant serves St. Petersburg, so you can fly into Orlando and then maybe travel around Europe, travel around Florida and then go to the West Coast. And then maybe fly back from St. Petersburg. So you have a number of options that you can consider, and we think that most of the time you ought to be able to find the price and the service you like to Florida.
Now, your air travelers through LVIA, down about how much this year?
We're down a little over 10% from the year before, which was not a good year.
Right.
So we're down about 26-27% from our peak.
Which was about 1 million travelers?
A little over a million passengers, right. And so this has been a difficult year for us, particularly financially, because the amount of revenue we receive to operate the airport is closely linked to the number of passengers that flow through it. So and the amount of flights and the size of aircraft that are provided at the airport. So it's been a difficult year. Fortunately, traffic in July and August was up, which just bucked the trend. We were having a real negative trend, and then all of a sudden things changed and it started to come back up, and we're pleased with that. We think that trend will hold through the end of the year. May not be dramatically up. And then I think from there on, it depends on the economy. And if the economy begins to improve, people will come back and fly.
With this difficult economy, is there any fear that the airport may not be able to stay afloat?
Well, I don't think there's any fear in the near future of the airport going away, in even the long-term future. I think that this is a strong market. There are 2.5 million people that live within 40 miles. This is a convenient facility for most of them, much more convenient than Philadelphia and Newark. So there's always going to be a market here, and there will always be someone who will want to serve it. Whether it's the service that the community thinks it needs and wants is a different question, but I think there will always be an airline available to make that decision. But in the near term, it's going to be a bit of a struggle, but we've been managing, and I'm sure we'll be able to get through it.
Lots more to talk about with you, George, and some big news to talk. So we'll be back with George Dowdy from the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority in just a little bit. Thanks so much for your time.
Sure.
Business travel has usually made up about 30% of all airline travel. The economic downturn has forced companies across the board to cut back spending. Travel is often at the top of the list for being cut. A recent study shows corporate travel has actually declined more aggressively than leisure travel, and it's not anticipated to rebound as quickly. So, what does that mean for LVIA? Tempo In-Depth's Crystal Fisher takes a look.
While most of us hit the snooze button as long as we can, before hitting the road to head to work, Millions of people track flight times to take off. Last year, more than 305 million business travelers took to the skies. That's about 35% of all air travel.
I have always believed that a face-to-face meeting with a customer is much more conducive to the final outcome of the business deal.
But face-to-face often means tarmac to takeoff for Bruce Hargis, Vice President of Sales and Operations for Air Products and Chemicals.
You know, out of the next 6 weeks, I'm only here a few days next week and then the week between the Europe and the Asia trip.
Normally, he says he spends about 150 days on the road or in the air.
During normal times, and these are not normal times, I typically spend probably 60 to 70% of my time on the road.
Bruce definitely isn't alone in checking in to head to work. Actually, historically, corporate travel has made up about 40% of the total travel market.
What is your final destination?
Chicago.
Air Products has a global travel program. We operate in 20 countries, and we've streamlined that all through one travel service provider. We do about 65,000 tickets per year, and that's a normal year.
Kathy Katinsky, travel manager for Air Products, points out this year's anything but normal. A recent market research study by Focusrite shows business travel's down 15%, pulling the corporate travel industry down to $85 billion from $101. Kathy says Air Products saw a similar shift.
Now, with the economy downturn, we're down probably about 40% this year. So out of those 65,000 tickets, about 26,000 are out of the United States, and probably about close to 40% are Lehigh Valley Airport users. So pretty significant amount.
So what does that mean for our local Lehigh Valley Airport? Susan Kittle directs business development for LVIA. She says the airport can't accurately track why people are flying.
Well, we could potentially have a business traveler on any one of our flights from early morning till the end of the day. So that's sort of, you can't really give a statistic for that.
But overall, she says travel's been down about 10% year to date at LVIA. She says through speaking with regional business travel managers, the airport recognized a trend.
What we see now, especially with business travelers, they're trying to hold back. Budgets aren't being done for next year yet, trying to see what the economy is doing.
But holding back might have serious repercussions. Booking less flights to cut costs, companies could be forcing airlines to cut back as well. Tony Iannelli is president of the Greater Lehigh Valley Chamber of Commerce.
The challenge always is, in our case, it's sort of good news and bad news. The good news is we have a very nice, attractive, quaint, cute airport. The bad news is when you're a mid-range city like this, it's hard to really maintain or generate the volume to keep the kind of carriers that we'd like to keep.
He says fewer travelers will result in fewer flights.
But it boils down to economics, and the economics are, if they do a flight, if the numbers aren't there, if they're not filling the seats, they're going to cancel.
Cancellations that drive up cost and push passengers to surrounding airports like Newark and Philadelphia.
It's harder to get a lower cost flight out of here. That sometimes drives bargain seekers to other places.
A shift Pete Ranka, Vice President of Regional Development for the Lehigh Valley Economic Development Corporation, says will cost us more than tickets. He says businesses look for strong regional airports when they're considering relocating to an area. He says that's one reason LVIA is so important to the community.
It is a gem for the area, and I think the big thing is cost. The location is great. It's a legitimate airport, and we need to recognize that. I don't think everybody in this community does.
Lehigh Valley Airport is, of course, the closest airport to Air Products, and it is very important both to the company and to the community as well. It's a great airport. It's small. It's easy in and out. Parking is simpler than at the major airports.
Small conveniences that add up to major differences for travelers like Bruce.
It's also a quality of life issue. I mean, to be able to leave locally saves not only the time, but just the general wear and tear.
Wear and tear Bruce doesn't take for granted, and neither do LVIA officials. In August, LVIA saw an increase of travelers, which they say is a step in the right direction. They say they hope this will continue so that LVIA can soar to new heights in the upcoming year. For Tempo In Depth, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.
Thanks so much, Crystal. Well, joining me again is George Dowdy. He's the executive director of the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority. And George is back with some big news recently announced from American Airlines, some more direct flights offered at Lehigh Valley International Airport.
That's right. American, after being away for several years from Lehigh Valley International Airport, is going to return with flights to Chicago. And we're very excited about that. It's a relatively recent announcement. We don't have a lot of detail on the schedule, but we're looking at apparently three flights a day to Chicago, and they will be competing with United Airlines. So when you get competition, things should get interesting.
Drive down those prices perhaps a little bit, which would be good, because it's just so convenient. One of the folks that's living here, I'm three exits away from the airport, and you would always love to travel out of there if you can get the price that you're looking for, and competition always helps that. You know, we also learned in Crystal's story about business travelers and Air Products as one example, and they mentioned that about 40% of their business travel flies out of Lehigh Valley International Airport. Just one large company, if you could get that other 60% to travel.
That would be great.
That would be great.
In fact, studies we've done is Air Products alone represents almost 1% of our business. So we're, you know, very pleased that they give us 40% of their business, and we'd be happy to take another couple chunks of it as well. But there are times, obviously, when it just doesn't work. Maybe an international flight to Europe might not work. But we do connect really well to international destinations in the Far East, both on United through Chicago and on Northwest, now Delta, through Detroit. So we still do a pretty good amount of international business. Of course, the airlines love the international passenger because they make a lot of money off of those people. And so that we try to make sure people are aware what the opportunities are.
What do you hear? Do you hear anything from business travelers that say, if you could do one thing at the airport, do this, and we would fly more through you?
I think fares remain the toughest problem for us. Nonstops being the second most difficult problem. But we do go to almost all the major hubs. Some of the smaller hubs that the airlines have been shrinking, like Pittsburgh, which is essentially gone, and Cincinnati, we've lost service to simply because the hub's not there anymore, or it's not there in the size that it was. We have a fair amount of nonstops to a number of important destinations, and we have at times pretty good fares. It's just a matter of being aggressive and trying to find the fare that works for you. But we recognize that on average we're going to be a little more expensive than the big guys.
Now, you mentioned in our last segment that your number one destination is Orlando, but number two is Chicago?
That's correct. Number two is Chicago. It's always been an important market from the Lehigh Valley. And because O'Hare is such a large airport and provides so many good connections, there's a significant demand on that route to go beyond Chicago to the west. So it's an important market for us, will continue to be.
Well, it fills out maybe 3, 4, and 5 after you hit Chicago and Orlando.
It varies. St. Petersburg is doing well because it now has nonstop service, so points in Florida. Fort Lauderdale is probably, I'm thinking these are top 10 markets. Dallas, which does not have nonstop service and certainly we think could support it.
Do you still do international? Do you head to Canada like you
used
to?
We still have flights to Toronto. Detroit is another, and Cleveland are both strong markets for us. They both have nonstop service available. So those are some of the more significant areas or destinations.
You've got some changes going on, some renovations in the works. Tell us about that.
We've finally been able to go forward with renovation of the main terminal. As you anyone who used the airport probably knows, we renovated the airside, which is where the gates are, and added a significant amount of capacity there about 10 years ago. And we're now taking the main terminal and renovating it. It was completed in the mid-70s. It has a mid-70s look, actually a deteriorated mid-70s look. But more important, all of the mechanical systems and electrical systems and everything that make the airport work, and the glass and all of these other components that are not as energy efficient, don't work as well as the products that are available today, are all going to be replaced with new systems, and that'll keep us going forward. And I think when we're done, when you walk into the airport, you will think it's a brand new facility, because essentially it will be.
How long until those renovations are complete?
Well, we have about another year for phase one to be completed, and then maybe a year after that, phase two. We can't do it all at once because we obviously have to continue to operate. So we're doing the west end of the airport first, where Continental and Northwest used to be that area, and where the restaurant was. That's now totally ripped out, and it's being redeveloped for a new ticket counter. And then we will have a new restaurant and other facilities in that area. And then we will come back for phase two, which actually will be divided into at least two sub-phases to complete that area going toward the east, where United is now and where Delta's counters are, if people remember that from the airport.
Now, in this difficult economy, how has it impacted your business? Have you had to change the way you've done business because of the down economy?
Absolutely. We've seen decreases in almost every aspect of our business, general aviation as well as airline business. Rental cars are down. Obviously, fewer people are flying, fewer people are renting cars. So we've seen this sort of contraction of revenue. And we've had to respond by reducing services where we can. The problem is that you still have the same size airfield. The grass still grows as fast as it did last year. So we have a certain amount of fixed cost that we have to cover. We have to do certain amounts of certain safety things that we always do. We have to provide firefighters. We have to provide police officers. So we've made reductions where we can in personnel. We have not laid off any full-time people, but we have reduced staff through attrition, and we have reduced the number of hours of part-time employees. And we've made some conversions from moving people from full-time to part-time, which saves us some money in benefits and other things. So we're doing what we can as quickly as we can to respond to that.
George Dowdy, Executive Director from the Lehigh Northampton Airport Authority, thanks so much for your information. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Finally tonight, here's a chance for you to explore the issue on your own. For more facts and figures on monthly travel breakdowns, head to the Bureau of Transportation Statistics at bts.gov. For tips on traveling safely and how to reduce your hassle at security, check out tsa.gov. To learn more about flights coming and going from the Lehigh Valley International Airport, go to lvia.org. Thanks so much for joining us, and happy travels.
Support for Tempo In-Depth is provided by the members of PBS 39.